I want to get this out of the way right away. I like to dress up for shows, but sometimes I make a misjudgment. My misjudgment in this case is that I've been out on the road now for 7 weeks. This is kind of the end of it, but not really. And I don't know if you know this about if you're on the road for 7 weeks, sometimes you put on a little more weight than you think. And you try and get into your tight show pants, you bend down to plug in your instruments, and you rip from the back of the seam all the way down to the middle bits. So, I'm going to try and do a demure curtsy every time I go down to pick up an instrument. But, you know, if you're of delicate sensibilities, just don't consider yourself forewarned. This song, I believe, is unique in the world, and I'm not saying that to brag. I'm just saying that because I think it's objectively true. I think this is the world's only mariachi disco tribute to a retired superhero. Start off with the saddest thing you know. Then you got your audience, and then it's all your show. A man's wife leaves you. Someone's robbing. Someone swallowed cyanide, someone strung up by a howling mob. Start off with the saddest thing. Miles Wadsworth makes in Junior this song when he's a tango. This song is called Dead Sailors. It refers to the old superstition about lighting your cigarette off a bar candle, which is that every time you do that, that a sailor dies. So there's two things about that. Number one is don't do that. It's like the opposite of Tinkerbell. The second thing is that the first time I ever played this was at a cabaret space in New York. It was called Le Poisson Rouge, the Red Fish. And it had about 50 or 100 tables, and each one of them had one of those little bar candles on it. And you know, the stage lights were really bright, so I couldn't see anything. It was dark except for these little white specks. It looked like an arm of the Milky Way spread out right in front of me. It was beautiful. And I said that thing about the bar candles. And all the way from the back of the room, somebody said, "They're not real." I said, "What do you mean they're not real?" And from all the way in the back of the room, the very last star of that galaxy popped up and started bobbing its way towards me through the darkness, closer and closer. And it landed right on the front of the stage between the two monitors. And I picked it up, and sure enough, it was a little plastic cylinder with an LED embedded in the middle of it. So I don't know what that's a metaphor for, but when I figure it out, I will write the sequel to this song.
So me and your dead sailors, we've been working hard.